हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेरी फाइन. माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर प्रशांत बागेश्वर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, एमएम कॉलेज धारवा. बिकॉज ऑफ लॉकडाउन ड्यू टू पैंडेमिक डिसीज COVID-19 और कोरोना वायरस, we couldn't complete our syllabus. So from today we are going to start video lecture series. Because of lockdown, before lockdown we were discussing unit number 5 about the alternating current. We have covered some of the portion of alternating current. So remaining topic I am going to cover through this video lecture series. So before going to start my first video lectures on alternating current, I would like to just review what we have studied before the lockdown. So review of alternating current. Actually I have told you, in this chapter we have to study 6 different circuits plus transformer. This is the important parts of the this alternating current. So out of these 6 circuits we have completed 3. Circuit first was, actually all these 6 circuits is about the application of alternating current to different 6 circuits. So out of these 6 circuits we have already covered 3 circuits. Now first one was AC applied to pure resistive circuit, and what we did here, just we consider a resistive circuit, pure resistive circuit means only resistor is there, resistor of resistance R, and to this resistor a source of alternating EMF is applied. And how we write, E is equals to E0 sine of omega t. And what we did to a pure resistor, we applied the alternating voltage source, and therefore in the circuit alternating current will be flow, and that we want to calculate, and we have calculated. So before that, this is the alternating voltage source. Its complex form written as E is equals to E0 e to the power j omega t. Okay, so this type of alternating voltage source we have applied to the pure resistive circuit, and we want to find out the alternating current. And we got it, and we got the expression just by applying the Ohm's law. Actually V is equals to IR. So in case of the alternating circuit, we can write here the alternating EMF across the resistor, it should be equals to I alternating current into resistance. So whenever you want to find out the current, alternating current, so it should be just ER by R. So if you put the value of ER, so this is, you can say ER or EMF across the resistor. So this is actually E0 e to the power j omega t divided by R. Peak value of EMF divided by total resistance of the circuit, and that can be called as the I0, peak value of alternating current. So I0 e to the power j omega t. So see what type of EMF we have applied. E0, E in j omega t, and because of this type of alternating current, alternating voltage, alternating current is I0 e to the power j omega t. If you look at both the equations, I have explained all these things in before the lockdown. So if you look both the equations, applied alternating source and the produced alternating current, in both the cases angle is omega t. So in what way applied EMF changes, in the same way the alternating current produced in the circuit is changes. So that's why we again draw the graph and all, but this is just as a revision. So if you draw the phasor diagram, I can see here the applied EMF and produced current, they are in phase. Why in phase? Because phase of applied EMF, and by that what alternating current is produced, phase is same, omega t omega t. So in phase, this means no phase difference, no phase difference. Okay, so in this way we have discussed application of AC voltage source to pure resistive circuit. Very similarly, what we have studied already about the second circuit, AC applied to pure inductive circuit. So diagram will be, see here it will consisting only inductor, and to this inductor, pure inductor, only inductor is there, and to this circuit alternating source of EMF is applied. Once again E across the L, it should be equals to E0 sin of omega t, or it in complex form E0 e to the power j omega t. What is our aim? Just to see what type of alternating current or how much alternating current flows in the pure inductive circuit. So again we can apply the Kirchhoff's law, the EMF across inductor is equals to what we write here, L into di by dt, from the what we have studied in the unit number 4. Unit number 5. Actually this is unit number 6. We have studied this thing in unit number 5. Okay. So if you solve this thing, you want to get the current. So you put the value of EL, that is E0 e to the power j omega t, simple mathematics, di by dt, and by taking the integration we can get the value of alternating current in the circuit, and it is found out to be what we write here, alternating current in the pure inductive circuit, it will be I0 e to the power j into omega t minus pi by 2. So look what type of EMF we have applied to the circuit and what alternating current we get here. The phase of applied EMF is omega t, but because of that what alternating current produced, phase is less than pi by 2 than the applied EMF. So this means if you draw the phasor diagram, so you will see the phasor diagram will be like this. Here applied suppose EMF alternating voltage source, and because of that what current is produced, alternating current produced, it is lagging behind the applied EMF by the phase pi by 2. Okay, so we know all this thing. Here if you think about the power in the pure inductive circuit, so power is actually the power can be obtained as formula is actually IRMS into ERMS into cos of phi, this phi. Here phi is 90 degree. And all these things we are doing by J operator method. We are all discussing using the J operator method. Okay. So, here P, IRMS, ERMS, root means square value of current, root means square value of the EMF, and we know, I have told you, E0 and ERMS related with each other. Similarly, I0 and IRMS. So this is the peak value of applied EMF, RMS value of applied EMF, peak value of alternating current, and root mean square value of alternating current. So we know actually ERMS is equals to E0 by root 2. Very similarly, IRMS is equals to I0 by root 2. So if you put these values here also, but here cos of 90, it is coming out to be 0. So therefore, you can say power in the inductive circuit is 0. So no power consumed. What you can say? No power consumed in pure inductive circuit. In pure inductive circuit. So this was about the second circuit. Now third circuit is AC applied to pure capacitive circuit. Diagram is very similar. Here there is the capacitor of capacitance C, and here a source of alternating voltage is applied. E is equals to E0 sine of omega t, or you can say it is in complex form. So EC across the capacitor, E0 e to the power j omega t. Again, by doing simple mathematics, again applying the loop equation here, we can write here the EMF across the capacitor, we can write it is equals to, or here again we want to find out what is the alternating current produced in the circuit. Again, current means, again we can directly go from the definition of current, that current is nothing but the rate of flow of charge, and here we have to take the you can say differentiation. In the last case, we have taken here integration, as current was in the differentiation. So we have taken here integration, and here we have to take the differentiation. Again, you know, Q is equals to C into V. So we can use this, and finally we get the alternating current in this circuit. So it should be equals to I is equals to, we can write here I0, then e to the power j omega t plus pi by 2. So exactly reverse thing happens here. Here the what we can say, here the alternating current is lagging by pi by 2 than the applied EMF, and here the alternating current in capacitive circuit is leading by pi by 2 than the applied EMF. Again, we can show the phasor diagram like this. Here again I say current, alternating current, which is this much, but here the applied EMF here to the capacitive circuit lagging behind. So you can see here this type of phasor diagram. So this all we studied before the lockdown. Here also we can find out the power by using the same formula, again cos of phi, that is 90, 0. So in this circuit also no power consumed. So remember here, very important thing, that what we have studied already before the lockdown. So I think दिस इज सफिशियंट फॉर फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर एंड राइट फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी वट वी हैव नॉट डिस्कस्ड. सो थ्री सर्किट्स वी हैव टू स्टडी इन कमिंग पीरियड. नंबर वन वी हैव टू स्टडी द यस वी हैव टू स्टडी द फोर्थ सर्किट एज अ एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज सोर्स टू एल आर सर्किट सर्किट विद कंसिस्टिंग एल एंड आर. पॉइंट नंबर फाइव विल बी एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज सोर्स टू सी आर सर्किट एंड लास्ट वन इज एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज सोर्स टू एल सी आर सर्किट. सो वी स्टॉप हियर एंड आई से स्टे सेफ स्टे एट होम एंड ऑल्सो स्टे पॉजिटिव. यू रीड यूनिट नंबर फाइव दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉट यू एंड यूनिट नंबर सिक्स अगेन यू गो थ्रू इट. इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी डिफिकल्टी यू कैन आस्क क्वेश्चंस यू कैन आस्क यूअर क्वेरीज. माय सेल नंबर इज विथ यू एंड इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज सोर्स टू एलआर सर्किट एंड इन कमिंग वीडियो लेक्चर्स वी आर ट्राइंग टू कंप्लीट ऑल योर सिलेबस. सो थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग मी. थैंक यू वंस अगेन.